Hey guys, it's a wonderful day today because this video is going to feature a lot about my favorite civilization to play, the Japanese. I'm going to be taking a look at towers in the HD expansions, and not only the Japanese unique tech, but also the new Arrow Slits technology that all civilizations get access to. I'm going to check out each of those techs on their own, and then together in the Japanese towers, and then math it up a bit and see how they compare to castles and bombard towers. Let's check it out. First, let's look at the Japanese unique tech. Now, I don't know how to say it, so I'm gonna go with Yasama. In the HD expansions, it's available for the Japanese in the Castle Age if you've built a castle. It's 300 wood and 300 food and adds 3 arrows to Japanese towers, meaning without any garrison, they fire 4 every round instead of 1. Now, I'm not gonna look at the effects of garrisoning villagers and other units into towers during this video, and the fact is, however many arrows you get with other civilizations putting units in towers, the Japanese just seem to get 3. More. Those 3 arrows are quite powerful because they're actually doing full damage as well, and we can see against a building with no armor, the tower is doing 6 damage per shot before Yasama and 24 damage per shot after, exactly 4 times as much. Against units with armor, it's the same thing, and every shot calculates the armor damage as usual, and we go from 4 damage per shot in this case to 16 after the tech. That means regardless of what unit you're firing at, you're always going to get 4 times the damage output if all the arrows hit them. One thing we notice though is the shots do occasionally miss. On a shot where 2 arrows miss, it only does 8 damage, so we're not getting all of that theoretical damage all the time. So let's take a closer look at what that accuracy is. Regular towers have 100% accuracy on non-moving targets, and my hypothesis is that one of the Japanese arrows is a regular 100% accuracy one, and the other 3 have a lower accuracy. One weird thing I noticed is that a tower with 1 arrow fires 9 or 10% faster than one firing multiple arrows, weirdly enough, so just looking at accuracy alone isn't telling the full story. At their maximum range, the 3 special Yasama arrows are definitely missing a lot, in addition to all firing slower. So if you're expecting the towers to do 4 times as much damage as the regular one, you'll be underwhelmed that the slower firing rate and arrow misses mean you're only getting about 70% of what you're expecting. It's as if instead of firing 4 arrows, it's firing about 2.8, which is definitely something we have to keep track of in any calculations of damage output, and we can't necessarily just multiply by 4 unless the units are very large or very close. Just to take it one step further, I decided to check if there's an accuracy difference between these extra arrows and the extra arrows from garrisoned units. And after a quick test, they seem to have indistinguishable damage output, so extra arrows all appear to be the same. So moving on, let's take a look at the Arrow Slits tech. It says here that it increases the attack of towers, and a quick test shows that it increases the watchtower attack by 2, the guard tower by 4, and the keep by 6. Interestingly, if we garrison enough villagers for 3 extra arrows, the attack in a watchtower goes from 8 to 26. That means if our original arrow is doing the 8 damage it says it is, those 3 extras are only doing 6. It's kind of obvious at this point that the arrow slits doesn't affect your extra arrows, and only the main one that I'm suspecting has 100% accuracy against non-moving targets. Trying it again with the keep, we see it goes from 15 damage after arrow slits to 31 when it fires 2 extra arrows, meaning they seem to be doing 8 damage, which is a very weird number since it's 1 less than the regular keep's damage output normally. If we compare how much the tech improves the attack of each type of tower, assuming some appropriate blacksmith techs, we can see an increasing payoff as you upgrade the towers. So with arrow slits, you're not just getting the regular improvements as you upgrade to guard and keep, but you're secretly getting even more from arrow slits relative to the new tower stats. Just for a comparison's sake, here's what the Japanese unique tech does to each of those towers as well. However you look at it, you're definitely getting way more out of the Japanese tech than you are out of arrow slits. Now let's put them together and examine the awesomeness that is the Japanese tower with Yasama and arrow slits. Funny story, Yasama actually means arrow slits, so I guess Japanese towers just have a lot of them. Let's compare them to the generic post-imperial keep from any old civilization without arrow slits. A regular keep in the expansions does 348 damage per minute to an outpost, which has no pierce armor. In HD, that would have been 319 because towers after the watchtower have one more attack. Okay, so not bad, but we don't see towers used all that often, so I guess 348 damage per minute isn't all that great. The post-imperial Japanese tower, ungarrisoned, does about 1400 damage per minute, or about 4 times as much. To test some more specific cases, against a paladin for example, whose pierce armor is going to negate those weaker arrows a little bit, the Yasama and Arrow Slit towers kill the paladin about 3 times faster than a normal tower. Against an elite Huskarl with very high pierce armor, the effect works out to about 4 times faster. And against an elite World Raider, the effect is closer to 3 again. It seems to depend on the unit, but it fluctuates between 3 and 4. But now for the real comparison that I'm curious about. How does the post-imperial Japanese defensive keep compare to a defensive castle? Post-imperial age, close range against an outpost, we get the castle doing about 2300 damage per minute, and the Japanese tower doing about 400 damage per minute less. Or put another way, the castle's doing about 22% more damage thanks to its extra arrow. The tower fires a bit faster than the castle, and it's 100% accurate at this range, so the fact it's doing 51 damage to the castle's 75 was balanced out a bit. This is really the theoretical maximum, but what about against Hazars at a bit longer range? This is where the castle starts to dominate, with almost 1200 damage per minute versus the Japanese tower's roughly 600, nearly twice as much. A couple of things are going on here. First of all, the castle seems to have 100% accuracy with all 5 of its arrows. Hazars are a bit easier to hit than infantry, but the Japanese towers still miss them quite a bit, and this isn't even at their maximum range yet, where it would be slightly worse. The other thing is now we're doing 27 damage instead of the 51 that we were doing against the outpost. 12 damage on the arrow that's 100% accurate, and 5 damage with the other 3 arrows. The castle, on the other hand, is doing 2/3 more damage per shot and is hitting with all of its arrows every time. For 1/5 the cost of a castle, what you're giving up is basically 3/4 of the garrison space, half the HP, half the attack power, the ability to make units from it, and the fact that the castle comes with 20 population space built in. What you're getting is a building that's easier to find space for in the middle of your town, more damage output per stone spent, and a much wider coverage of your town for the same amount of stone. Now we're giving the Japanese the short end of the chopstick here, and this isn't actually a fair test. What happens when we use similar amounts of stone for both sides? Well, suddenly the Japanese towers combined do more than 2.5 times the damage as the castle under the same testing conditions. So there's a few ways to interpret this, I'd say. It really depends on what you're looking for in the building for your situation, but there would be some justification to replacing a defensive castle on your town or mining camp with 2 or 3 defensive towers to save a bit of stone while getting the same firepower and relative safety from raids. Now what about comparing them to a bombard tower? Japanese don't get bombard towers, but I'm curious how they compare anyway. Here I have a Portuguese bombard tower and my post-imperial Japanese keep. Since the Japanese keep fires 3 times for every 1 bombard tower shot, the theoretical pure damage against an outpost is in favor of the Japanese. That's not reflected in reality though, against a post-imperial unit with 6 pierce armor at a distance, where 60% of the Japanese tower's offensive potential disappears into missed shots and pierce armor. In reality, it becomes about 1200 damage per minute to 600 again, almost identical to the results with the castle test. Now this test makes bombard towers look like the real alternative to castles for the same kind of firepower but with a lot less stone, but there's a few quick things I want to point out about that. First of all, this is all against a stationary unit with 1000 HP. In reality, a bombard tower hitting a Hazar, or especially something like a halberdier, is going to waste a lot of that damage. In a scenario with 4 Hazars harassing villagers, we see very similar results between a Japanese tower protecting the villagers and a bombard tower. This is partly because of the wasted damage, but also because cannons move so slowly through the air that even close range, a unit doing some raiding can happen to dodge them fairly easily. As the unit size and HP gets smaller, maybe a halberdier or hand cannon, these effects are going to increase even more. A castle had almost identical damage output to the bombard tower against the 10,000 HP stationary Hazar, but it's by far the most practical in the experiment. On the other hand, you're getting that for the cost of 5 times the stone. Speaking of cost, let's wrap up by talking about costs for a second. Here's the cost of all the things talked about in the video. Ignoring the blacksmith techs, ballistics, and chemistry, which I'm going to assume you'll probably be getting anyway, going the tower route takes 1,050 wood and food by post-imperial, and requires a castle. The bombard tower, on the other hand, costs significantly less to research, but don't forget the 100 gold cost of each bombard tower. As much as I'm a Japanese pusher, I'm not going to say that their keeps will always be the best choice here. The problem is castles just do too many different things to make for a straight comparison. I'm sure there's different situations where each one of the three options will excel in, particularly against certain unit types or whatever, but I leave those judgment calls to you, and at least now you know some of the numbers going on behind the decision. As always, thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you next time.